Hi everyone, I'm glad you can join us on this week's episode of Times of Refreshing Encouragement for Pastors' Wives. Let me start by saying a big thank you to everyone that follows us on our social media platform and to all of you that have subscribed to our YouTube channel. Thank you for the likes, thank you for the comments and the questions. You are highly appreciated. Let me remind you to keep them coming and God bless you. Today, we want to continue on the topic of our identity as pastors' wives. In the last episode, we said that you should not be defined by any other thing but by what God has created you to be. That is very true. I hope you are trying your best to be who God has called you to be. I hope you are trying your best to put your talents and your gifts to use. As you do that, I want to say once again, that you are doing exactly what God wants you to do. But today we want to look at this issue from another angle, from the angle of embracing your ministry as a pastor's wife. Being a pastor's wife is a ministry within a ministry. And when we come back from the break today, we're going to be talking more about this. I don't want you to go anywhere. We'll be back shortly. Stay tuned.
Make sure to like our Facebook page at Times of Refreshing with Pastor Toyin and subscribe to our YouTube channel at Times of Refreshing with Pastor Toyin, and you will be truly blessed.
Welcome back. The Bible in the book of Genesis 2:24 says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and his mother and shall cleave to his wife, and the two shall become one." What I'm trying to say is that once you're married to a pastor or your husband becomes a pastor, automatically you become a co-pastor. Automatically you are also called into the ministry with him. That is why as pastors' wives, we must make effort that we succeed in the role that God has given unto us. Being a pastor's wife is a ministry within the church ministry. A pastor's wife is the person that has a job without a job description, that take on roles as need be. We cannot afford to fail in these duties. Several times people call us first ladies. Being a first lady is not a positional role. Rather, it's a relational role. It's a role that God has given unto us as a pastor's wife. A role where we will need to relate with a lot of people, both in our homes and in the church and everywhere. That is why our first ministry that we need to embrace is our home. You must embrace your home, the ministry that God has committed to your hands. What does that mean? The first ministry that God has given unto you is to be the helpmeet to your husband. It's for me to be the helpmate to my husband. We are supposed to be their greatest cheerleaders, to be their confidant, their prayer partners. We must take time to pray for our husbands, even as they work in the ministry. Several times, the pastor of the church, your husband, might be burdened. He's looking at you to be able to pour himself onto you and to be able to see you as a shoulder to cry on, so to say, us to rest upon. We must see this as a very important role, because if there's no peace in the home, there'll be no peace in the church. We must be the pastor's wife that makes this job easier for husband rather than making it difficult for them. And as we call upon God, God will help us in this. What about our children? The popular belief out there is that pastor's children are wayward children, because it is believed that pastors do not have enough time with their children. This should not be our story at all. We should not be caught in this way. The Bible says we should train our children the way they will go, and when they grow up, they will not depart from it. Let us not be pastors' wives who do not look into the affairs of the children. We must make sure we guide and teach our children the way of the Lord. We must be there for them. We must be listening ears to our children. You can never be too busy for your children, because if your children do not get your attention, they will seek it out there. You don't want that to happen. The information out there is the information of the world. But you as a parent need to step up so that you are there for your children. I'm not saying that the pastor, your husband, will not be a part in bringing up the children. Of course, he's the father and is expected to do his part. But because most times the pastors are very busy, we also need to step up as pastors' wives. We must look into the affairs of running the home. Our home must be a comfort for both our husband, our children, and every other person that God has put in our care. First ladies, we must also be sure we are available for the church. There are so many things that we need to look into in the church. I'm not saying we should be a jack of all trade. We cannot do it alone. That is why, as pastor's wife, we must also learn to delegate. The titles to women, the Bible says, must guide the younger women, must also lead them. We are leaders just like our husbands. We must be ready to lead and guide people to the right things to do as children of God. You must also make effort to be friends with people in the church. A lot of pastors' wives come into the ministry with the assumption that they are not going to be liked by the church members. Wipe this completely off your mind. I'm not saying that this does not happen. It does. But even as the church members have their role to play, we also have our roles to play as pastors' wives. The only way we can succeed in embracing our ministry as the pastor's wife is to be friends with a lot of people in the church, with actually everyone in the church. You're going to say that this is not possible. I'm sure about that, because there are some people that will not want to be your friends. But we must still try at accommodating everybody, because these are the people God has called us to relate with. Be quick to forgive. Be available for people. Let people reach you. Don't be the proud pastor's wife that people cannot reach. People must be able to reach us. And those that are difficult, there's nothing you can do about them but to pray for them. You must keep praying. While we were yet sinners, the Bible says Jesus Christ died for us. It is not impossible for us to love even the unlovables. Try your best at being open, available to people, and God Almighty will back you up. Today, I want to leave you with this word. Don't ever think anything is unaccomplishable. You can accomplish whatever you set your mind to. If you put God in the equation, you'll be able to embrace your role and your ministry as a pastor's wife. As we go away this week, try out some of these things that we discussed. I'm sure it's going to work for you. Thank you for watching. See you next time.